athletics, so I'm going to be working on this little painting for a while today, carrying on with this. So what I've done, and it's been a while since I've worked on this because of the pandemic, and I couldn't get into my studio. But now I'm kind of coming back at it. I've been away for a while, so it's all kind of new and different. I had, if you remember, a whole bunch of colors underneath this thing, and I just painted really wild on it. I was reviewing, I have a video of what this was like before I was working on it, earlier, and there's just so many colors and everything. And then I covered it up with these lighter areas, these bigger shapes. And this is something I tend to do a lot. I go from a more chaotic, throw everything in the kitchen sink in it. There's just something about that that it's clarifying to just let everything come out. And then kind of I reduce. And so I've reduced a lot, and now it's actually a little boring. And so I'm gonna go back in. But I'm going to go back in with, I'm going to be scraping lines to this and using pencils and sort of drawing on it. I might glaze a little. I'm going to lose this a little bit now and bring some of that, some of the spontaneity and some of the different surfaces, get them richer. This is just not interesting enough at all, these flat areas. And these can become really amazing surfaces once paint is applied to them, and glazing, and who knows, I might end up changing the design of this a lot. It's not amazing right now, it's okay. So that's what I'm gonna start doing. I'm gonna start, the paint's fairly thick, so I'm gonna be scratching lines in here, and not really outlining anything, but letting these lines, and these will be lines, especially when I glaze, they're gonna have their own composition, their own design to them. I use this tool, this big old thing I made. This is a giant T-square. I need a bigger one for this painting, but at least this is fairly big. It would be nice if it was bigger so I could just run with it. But most T-squares you find are 4 feet, and this is, I've made this bigger so we can work on paintings. This is on canvas, so I'm not scraping too hard because I don't want to cut the canvas. Scratching through to other layers until we start reviewing history. moves your eye through the whole picture. scraping through, it's basically like drawing, you know, drawing on this by removing paint. Thank you. I'm spray fixing the drawing a little bit. See how it's just getting more interesting just by manipulating the surface. So what I want to do now is I'm going to use some glaze on this and start bringing up the surface. Painting this large, I have to, I pretty much make the art on the art, you know, and mixing the glaze in a bucket that I can bring. I can't do it on a palette. There's not, I need more than, you know, I need a bunch for this size of painting. So I'm just making a kind of dirty stain color. This is transparent earth yellow, Gamblin. It's a really transparent golden color. I mix a little black with it. triple lot, a really fine steel wall. And I'm just getting a little bit of dirt, sort of like paint on the surface. You can see now it's all been pushed back and things are falling away and there's just way more richness of surface. And you know, I've worked on it, I've touched every part of the picture, and that's cool and connects me to everything that's going on. And now when this dries, I come back in and I'm gonna put more clean paint back on. I'm just kind of working on that surface and building this up. But this creates a lot of depth, right? The glaze drops things back. Things are going back and forward. And yeah, it's kind of messy, but there's some great surfaces now that are interesting in and of themselves. And so that's what's going on with this. So this needs to dry, and then I'll come back into it. And this can change radically. This might totally change. This is still very much, whatever. I just have to just keep kind of going with it. You just grab this and turn this camera around. Hey guys, I just thought I would share this thing in here. God, it's hot in here and it's a big painting. It's amazing, it's tiring. That stain quality, that just changes the surface and just drops everything back and it just makes it so much more interesting just to look at, So I want to have that freshness. A lot of times artists talk about, you start something and it's so fresh and then you just lose it and you get overworked. Well, what I just did to that painting, now it's all fresh again because you can see I was just throwing stain on it. Like there's nothing that feels precious or tight about that. And so you can make your work, it can feel really fresh, even though you might have worked on it for weeks and weeks and weeks. It's sort of interesting. Good, Leah. I'm so glad that you're found getting some help with watching stuff. I know. That's totally the way I learn. Absolutely. Hey, Michelle. Okay, cool. Well, go to sleep, Michelle. I think you're in Australia. Anyway, hey, Rowena. Nice to see you. Gordon. Hi. Haven't talked to you in a while. I think you're still in LA making art. Anyway, I just thought I would share this with you guys. And it's just so cool, all the stuff you guys are making in the group. And it's just really fun. And I'm finally kind of excited because I'm working here more because they just seem to relax the restrictions. And there's not a lot of people in my office, in my studio. So it's just me and AJ here. So so. Kind of excited about this now, much more excited than I was about half an hour ago. Okay, you guys, let me just scroll down here. Kara, hi. Sandy, good to see you. So anyway, I'll be in touch. Hope you guys are doing great. Okay, bye.